I question reality as I am currently witnessing it. Although I cannot differentiate between both reality and fiction, for the line is blurred. Stuck in a pile of rocks swiftly crashing down a mountain at very high speeds, figuratively speaking. My previous description was in fact in relation to me, so one could understand my plight of escaping what is truly real. I wish for you to open your eyelids, so that you may reveal your pupils. Now look, with your pupils so that you may witness the bright blue sky above us, albeit with a few clouds. You can see that I am a child of poverty, not necessarily of a third world country, but for other reasons. But do not give me sympathies for my depressingly low income. I do not require it because I easily go to and fro, easily letting myself go of stress and problems even as the wind blows harshly, or when there is little to no wind at all, regardless of whichever way the wind is actually blowing at the time, if at all it does not actually affect me in any way, shape or form, to myself, at least. Mother of whom I love dearly, I just committed first degree murder against a member of the male category. I did so, by applying a handgun directly to his forehead, right between the eyes. I then used my index finger, to slowly but surely push the trigger of said handgun, which is in fact a 9mm pistol. Because of said pistol, this man is now lying on the ground, deceased before my eyes, his corpse beginning to rot away. Mother of whom I love dearly, I had just kickstarted my life in a nearby apartment, of which I pay for with my own money from my old job I just started working at. But because I have gone and murdered this fellow person, I will now proceed to lose everything I have desperately earned. Oh mommy, sounds of hopelessness and despair fill my voice. It was not my intention to make you shed any tears of sadness, or any tears at all, for that matter. Simply put, if, in some way, I turn out to be absent, and not by your side again at this exact time of day, the following day, of which just so happens to be 2:26 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, proceed gracefully with your own life, so that I may not intercept and corrupt it, live under the pretense that no matter what you do, it does not actually matter to anyone anymore. I see at this time, that time has been a curse all along, and it is well overdue. The approximated time of which I will pass on and die and has finally arrived. The mere thought of thinking of such a moment gives me goosebumps, and shakes my spine with cold. Within these moments my body simultaneously aches all over, both when I am awake and asleep. I bid everyone I know farewell for their futures, as I will no longer participate in it. I must depart feverishly from this cold, wretched world, and I must leave for my sake. I am truly disappointed as well. I must leave everyone I know behind and face my own known problems head on, without being in denial. Oh mommy, sounds of moaning and depression fill the sound leaving my mouth. I would never wish in all eternity to pass away my life. There have been times at which I truly wish I was never conceived from your womb, and had never been brought into this world whatsoever. In my vision, I have discovered a shadow-like figure of a male being. Entertaining clown, funny clown that sings, will you perhaps do a dance known as the fandango? Several strikes of white and yellow flashes, that attack the ground and metal objects, they scare me exceptionally well. Galileo, an Italian astronomer, physicist, engineer, philosopher, and mathematician played a significant role in scientific progress in the 17th century. Such a fact is so interesting to me that I feel beholden to myself to repeat his name 3 more times. Galileo, 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 and Figaro, who is an essential character in several different plays, such as The Barber of Seville. They are eminent and illustrious persons. I am merely an insignificant child of poverty. Nobody truly has feelings or sympathy for me, although, I myself am likely fishing for pity. This child is merely an insignificant victim of poverty, born into his disgraceful life on little to no income from his family. To show mercy, if you will, and spare him from his unfortunate fate that you wish to cast upon him. Easily go to and fro, easily letting myself go. Will you perhaps let me be free from your judgment just this once, dear Allah? No, we refuse to let you be released from your crime. Let this child be free from you, please. Dear Allah, no, we refuse to let you be released from your crime. Let this child be free from you, please. Dear Allah, no, we refuse to let you be released from your crime. Please share mercy upon me, for I do not deserve this. We refuse to let you be released from your crime. Please share mercy upon me, for I do not deserve this. We refuse to let you be released from your crime. Please, I beg you, let me free just this once. Oh, we deny you. 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 Oh, Mamma Mia, here I go again. How can I ever be set free from the resistance? One of the many princes of hell has personally gone out of their way to dedicate a devil to my suffering. For my suffering. For my suffering. Do you honestly think with your strength you have the power to stop me and disrespect me by spitting in the general direction of my face? Do you honestly think that you can give love and care to me, then suddenly abandon me alone, so that I may be left to die on disgraceful terms? Oh, child that has just been born, you cannot perform this act to my very self. I will not allow it. Oh, child that has just been born. I absolutely must escape this tragedy. I absolutely must escape this tragedy in this position that I am in this very instant. Regardless, it does not actually affect anything at all. When I think about it, any normal person, or even a fool, could notice and see it with their very eyes. Regardless, these events do not actually change anything. Regardless, these events do not actually change the outcome of my destiny, in my personal belief. Regardless of whichever way the wind is actually blowing at the time. Bitch, you guessed it!